you know what, God, then help me to find the person that you want me to be with.
Right.
And I prayed for him. And that's what God gave me.
That was great.
Welcome back to my channel, guys. If you have not subscribed yet, then please make sure that you click the subscribe button below.
Right now,
and
do it.
Join the revolution. But before we get too far, guys, just tell the people who you are. Just give them a little, you know what I mean?
I'm Dise. That's my fiance, Rehu. And we go by Rehu Dise. And yes, we're all about God. If you just look at our name, Rehu Dise, right?
God in the center.
G-O-D in the center, God. Mm-hmm. In the center of this relationship.
We did a part one video of this topic. So let me tell you something. If you're going to start here, God, you're not going to understand. So please head on over to their channel. Check out the part one that we did on their channel. When you go check out the video, guys, please do leave a comment.
Don't just watch. Yeah, please.
Pay attention.
Yes.
Listen.
Take notes.
Yes.
Your Bible, have it ready. Have your Bible ready. Have your Bible ready. Whether it's physical, digital, you do what you gotta do.
Exactly. And please do click the subscribe button and please join their family. Anyway, let's get straight into it. On their channel, we spoke about the mistakes. Some of the mistakes that as Christians we make.
Yeah.
Correct.
With our knowledge or without our knowledge. Yeah. And basically how to learn from them, how to work on them.
Yeah.
Now we're gonna continue with that. We're gonna be talking about limitations. Putting a limitation on the hand of God.
Yeah.
God is not limited.
No, God.
He's limitless. But it is you, it is me, it is us who sometimes put a limit.
And that's the problem.
Yeah. On the hand of God.
I'm thinking of the scripture. You talk about limitations.
Yeah.
And immediately I'm drawn to that beautiful scripture where Paul says, but God can do exceedingly.
Abundantly.
Above all.
Imagine.
Ask or imagine. Mm. According to the power that worketh
in you.
Amen.
You see, that's it. So limitation. The power that worketh in you. I mean, if he can do above all exceedingly, why are we asking for little?
Yeah.
Exactly.
You know?
Why are we saying, God, if you can just get me through this. God wants to do more than just.
And speak life into it as
that's
well.
It.
So if you say it can just, say God. Do it.
Exactly.
You know, action words. That's what words you need to use. But you need to use the word of God in collaboration.
Exactly.
But then where's the mistake then, Birgitta? Why then are some believers limiting God?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Well, the mistake of people, like you said, is you need to speak life. Proverbs 18:21. Yep. Life and death is in the power of the tongue. And he who loves to talk will reap the consequences.
That's it.
So, that being said, you need to be careful what you're saying with your mouth.
Yeah.
There's this part of Judges.
Yeah.
The angel of God appeared before Gideon. Now, Gideon, right,
was
in the lowest family of the lowest tribe. There's there's rats, there's mice. Then there was him and his family.
Yeah, oh, my goodness.
But the angel of God appeared to him and said, mighty warrior.
Oh, wow.
Imagine a whole mighty warrior. What?
Imagine.
To someone who is low.
You're a mighty warrior.
A whole angel comes to you and says, mighty warrior. What am I trying to say to you is, sometimes you limit the hand of God by not believing in God's prophecy, in God's word for your life and how God, who God says you are.
Exactly.
You want to believe who other people say you are or whatever, but that's not who you are. No. There is so much power in I am.
Yes.
Oh, I am.
Yes.
God sees a mighty warrior, but what are you saying?
Hallelujah.
I am a failure.
Yeah.
I am not good enough. I am poor.
Yeah.
You know, I am
ugly.
Depressed.
Yeah. Mm.
I am ugly. You're claiming all these things.
Yeah.
Remember, life and death is in the power of
the tongue.
Your tongue.
That's it.
Now, there is God saying that you are a mighty warrior. You are rich. You are brave. You are you are worthy. You are loved. You are protected. You are wanted. You are needed. And here you are saying, I am a failure.
You know, I'm just thinking as you're speaking, and it's so powerful, man. We limit the hand of God because of our lack of knowledge of who God
as
is.
Well.
Yes. Who God is and who God says I am.
And I want to read this verse. Hold on.
Yep.
Jeremiah 32:27.
Yeah.
Yep.
And it says, I am the Lord, the God of all mankind.
Mm.
Is anything
too hard
anything
is it
too hard
nothing
for me?
Nothing
is
Things are hard for humans.
Yeah.
Things are hard for us. Sometimes simple waking up in the morning, guys.
It's hard. On a winter's morning.
Okay.
It's extremely hard. Yeah. But for God, that thing in your mind that you say is impossible to God, what's the big deal?
All you have to do is literally go to God humbly and ask Him for it.
Exactly.
And He shall deliver. That's all.
Why are you asking for small things from a great God? Are you trying to say that He can only manage
small
and not the big?
You must realize at some point, it's not even a reflection of you.
No.
You are making it a reflection of God. Again, it goes back to comparing God to man. You see the limitations in who you are.
Yeah.
And you equate it that to the limitation. You think God is also going to struggle with it.
Yeah. Yeah.
No.
Are you doubting the power of God in your life by what you are asking for? By what you are believing? Remember, God does not only call the qualified, but He qualifies the called.
Amen.
And God has called you.
Amen. In fact, Luke 1:37. If we can just turn our Bibles to Luke 1:37.
Okay.
And we're talking about literally, is there anything impossible?
37.
For God? Is there anything impossible for God?
Luke 1:37 says, "For nothing is impossible with God."
Nothing. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter how big or small my prayer is, what I'm trusting God for, what I need. Is it a pass of my exam? Is it a healing for my mother, my father, myself?
It's your faith.
Is it whatever it is?
Your
it's
faith.
All about faith.
What is faith?
Okay, so Hebrews 11 says faith is the confidence that what we hope for will actually happen.
Amen.
It gives us assurance about things we cannot see.
One of the mistakes that we make, which limits the hand of God, is not having faith. You know what I mean?
True.
You need to have faith, because it is when you believe in God and what He will do. If you have the faith of a mustard seed, you will tell the mountain to move.
Yes.
And it will move. And what is that? That is faith.
That's faith.
And in terms of telling the mustard seed to move, that goes with another verse, which is that faith without works is dead. Meaning, you have to take the works to command that mountain to move.
Correct.
You have to apply for that job.
Yeah.
You have to put works. You have to position yourself by faith to receive what you want to receive. Why?
Right.
God blesses the works of your hands.
Yeah.
No works?
Yeah.
No blessings.
You know what? And it's please go to Hebrews 11:6 while I'm
Hebrews
busy. Six. If you want to impress God, you're not going to move Him with the length of your prayers. You're not going to move Him by your dress code and your
money
or whatever the case may be, or how you portray yourself in front of other believers. I'm a child of God. You know, I got my Bible in my hand and my suit is on.
Exactly.
And I speak the lingo of the Christians. No, that's not going to move
God.
It's
not about that.
Faith
God
is
says
God. Listen
it
to what God
is
says.
Impossible to please God without faith.
Yeah.
There we go.
Anyone who wants to come to Him must believe that God exists.
That's it.
And that He rewards those who sincerely
seek Him. And that's the only way you're going to move God. And again, like our sister said, even faith is small as a mustard seed.
Exactly.
You guys have seen it. So small, but you can move the mountain.
Yeah.
Do
exactly.
not doubt. Doubt. Remind me of doubting Thomas. So here's the scene. Jesus has risen. It's the third day. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Everybody's waiting.
Jesus. Okay. Now they're believing that He's alive, right? But Thomas is there saying,
there's always that one guy.
But did you see?
Are you sure?
How do you know? So there is He standing there, like, guys, come on, you guys are believing and all that.
Me, I want to see it.
And in comes Jesus. Not opening the door, but walks through the door. And so shows Him the wounds and says, come on, Thomas, why are you doubting? This is me.
Exactly.
And don't be that Christian. Don't be that believer. Don't make that mistake. Believe, take God by His word.
Yeah. Exactly.
He did say that you need to test Him. So why not?
Exactly.
You know, test God. But according to His word and what is written.
Amen. Sure.
And don't be misled and think that if you don't have faith or if your faith is wavering, that it's because you're a bad Christian.
Yeah.
You're a bad person. Guys, even people who walked with Jesus, Peter,
a whole Peter,
who saw what God did.
Yes.
Peter.
When he was commanded to walk on the water and come to Jesus.
Of course,
his faith was there.
Yeah.
In the middle, he started to drown. Why?
Of course,
he lost faith. And Jesus said, you of little faith.
You of little faith.
Why did you doubt?
Why?
It happens sometimes that you are like, you know, doubting a bit, shaking a bit.
True. True.
Because human fear comes in the way.
It does.
And that's where you need to differentiate. God is supernatural.
Yes.
We are the natural
in the
world.
Same plane field.
Exactly.
It does not.
Peter opened his eyes and he took his took his eyes off the supernatural.
Yeah.
Off of God.
Yeah, and looked
out of faith.
Yeah.
And he out of the supernatural. Mm. And he started to see natural. Mm. He saw water, he saw sharks. I mean,
yeah.
So guys, there are times where things will happen that shake your faith.
Yeah.
But remember to keep your eyes on the things above.
Of course.
Remember to keep your eyes on the supernatural. And again, it's a mistake. It happens. So if you out there right now are going through a rocky moment, a hard time, remember God called you to come to Him, to walk on the water.
Mm.
You belong there where you are and where you belong there. God called you. You know?
Somebody might be saying, but Benita, I hear you speaking so confidently about trust God and have the faith. But someone's like, no, but how do I get this faith?
Yeah.
You know, do I pray for faith? You know, some people are like, God, please increase my faith. Oh, Lord, please. I need more faith. I need more faith. But the Bible is clear that faith only comes from hearing the word of God.
And good news.
Good news.
The good news.
Let's qualify that. That is in Romans chapter 10, verse, is it 17? Just look at that. Okay. So, faith will grow once you dig into the word and you own the word.
Mm-hmm.
There's a difference. You got to own the word because once you make the word your own and you ingest it, man, it grows. Faith bubbles up and bubbles up and bubbles up. Do you want to just qualify that?
Yeah, so Romans 10:17 says, so faith comes from hearing, that is, hearing the good news about Christ.
About Christ.
About Christ.
About Christ, the good news about Christ. And that's how faith will grow. And, and then that's when...
So a lot of your faith comes just from, you know, feeding your soul, feeding yourself with the word of God.
Amen.
You know, reading your Bible, you know, praising and worshiping God.
Spending
and knowing
time,
and knowing who God is and knowing who you are in Christ, like we said.
Yeah.
And things like going with God, like there's nothing not wonderful about it.
Yeah.
When you're with God, God is love. There's wonderful things that come out of being
love.
With God.
Mm.
There's health.
There's health.
There's peace.
There's, you know,
there's joy.
Yeah. There's so many attributes that come with walking with God.
Oh,
God is not going to lead you into a den of lions.
No,
God will
not
lead you into something
definitely
that you cannot handle.
Exactly.
So if you go with God,
there's
just nothing but glory and amazing things that will happen.
Amen. And see God first, putting God at the center of your life, of your
relationships.
Mm-hmm. No matter.
I love how you guys said that. Your relationships. This is, yes, guys. This is the couple, guys. Yes. Yes. There we go. And how have you guys made sure that you put God at the center of your relationship?
Okay, so I'm going to talk about my experience first, where I had to first, as an individual, know my relationship with God.
Yeah.
You know, who is God? What connection do I have with him first? And that's why I could actually say, you know what, God, then help me to find the person that you want me to be with.
Right.
And I prayed for him. And that's what God gave me. God gave me a man that could help me decide what church to go to.
Yeah.
So he led me to a man that could help me to be more connected with God.
Mm-hmm.
And that for me is perfect because, and then he can actually then be in the center of our relationship. Because if I knew Christ and he knew Christ individually, then we can together have Christ to move forward.
Yeah, no, no. Similar to me. In fact, I want to put it this way. Christ came before she came.
Yes.
You understand?
Obviously.
So I knew my God before I knew my fiance now.
Yeah.
So it was the relationship I had with him first, initially, that I had to bring across to her. And you know that saying that says, the God in me knows the God in you.
And that's it.
And that's how we've connected. And that's how we can actually have Christ
in the center
of our relationship.
Yeah.
And that's pivotal for everybody.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And it's nice to know that he loves God more than me.
Yeah.
I would
love God more.
And that's perfect. That's
then
like,
I would never want him
to love me more than
God.
Anything.
I couldn't.
God, especially God. Like, don't love me more than God.
Yeah.
Love God first, know your relationship with Christ, because when you pass away, you are going all by yourself.
You don't go
together. So work out your salvation. You know, let us work out our salvation. Then together we can work out our salvation for our children, help them and lead them.
That's true. But now, Lisa, tell me, now, how does someone out there now think, okay, how do I invite God into my relationship? Could be a love relationship between boy and girl,
or friends, or parents,
or whatever, but, or siblings. How do you get God in the center?
You need to make a conscious effort to invite God, to talk about it, to pray and be like, guys, I'm going through this. Can we pray together? Can you? Like, you have to take the steps. It won't just happen. When you're chilling, it won't just happen. Yeah. You need to say, guys, today, you know, the same way you make our plans to chill.
Yes,
make plans to pray. Something that is coupled with that is, are you ashamed? Yes. Anyone who will shame you for believing in God is not meant to be your friend.
No, it's a no-go zone.
Exactly.
Romans 1:16.
For I am not ashamed of this good news about Christ. It is the power of God at work, saving everyone who believes, the Jew first and also the Gentile.
You see, so they go on worshipping other things. Mm-hmm. Privately, mm-hmm. and then yet they're ashamed. But here's Paul saying to Romans, but I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of God.
Exactly.
And you need to bring that boldness in any relationship.
Exactly.
Come boldly saying, hey, I don't come alone. I don't come alone here. I come with my God. So are you going to accept him or not? And if you do, then we're going to have a good time.
That reminds me of an important point that you said.
Yeah.
But guys, it is not your responsibility to prove God is real. You must tell people about him.
Amen.
And what he's done in your life.
Amen.
And be honest,
you are a living testimony of the grace
and
of God.
Amen. God will then take over and prove that he's real.
Amen. He works.
So let's also remember.
So let God do what he needs to do.
Amen.
Let God be God.
Yes.
Yeah. To simply put, he doesn't need your help.
Amen. Amen.
That's it. That's it for today, guys. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe. Please go subscribe to their channel.
Okay.
They are a beautiful couple. They're very real.
Thank
They're
you.
Also so deeply rooted in God.
Yes.
God,
it is very inspiring. So, guys, that's it. God bless you. Peace and love, guys.
Thank you, guys. Ciao.